secret place.
Jesus.
And I'm talking to the Lord.
Jesus.
Because I got a need that only God can meet.
Jesus.
Anybody got a need that only God can meet? You can say what your mama say. You can treat me how you want to treat me, but I'm going to stay right here until God show up for me. Because I got a right now situation that's going to take right now faith. And if I don't give God something to work with, church folks will talk about you, nominate you, scandalize you. If you don't believe it, just start getting blessed by the Lord and see what they say. I ain't dogging church folks, but I'm a church folk too. Now, let me tell you, but I'm letting you know the truth about it. Everybody ain't happy when you get blessed. Everybody ain't on your side. Everybody don't see like you see. Everybody ain't gonna take your point of view. Everybody
so that's real.
That's real.
Hannah had to find out the hard way.
Come on now.
She said, look, I'm not drunk. But I need something from God.
Jesus.
And if God don't show up for me,
come on, God.
Surely I'm not going to make it.
Jesus.
So what Hannah did, she stole away in a secret place. And she began to talk to God. And when she began to talk to God, things started changing and working in her favor. She said, wait a minute. You might not understand my need, but I need God to do something for me. She said, I need a man child. She wasn't just thinking about herself. She was thinking about her husband as well. She didn't want to just give him a child. She wanted to give him a man child. That way she would have honor and he would have honor. You got to think about it every time. See, you got to remember her husband. He gave her a double portion because she could not do what he needed her to do. But he loved her anyway. And what Hannah did, she just returned the favor. She went and shifted that thing. And she turned it around. I don't want you to just bless me. Bless my husband as well. Give him a man child. Somebody that he can have honor with. Because in those days, for a man not to have a man child was considered dishonorable.
Come on, Prince, please help us.
I need honor. So I had to learn. The only way I can get honor and favor was to not just think about me, but think about everybody else around. Hallelujah. I told her to keep me informed. She did like this. I think I got what, 4 or 5 minutes? Okay, 5 minutes. I gotta cut it off, y'all. Hallelujah. She told me, she said, I don't just want any child, I want a man child because I want you to bless my husband as well. And he told me, he said, look, God already done granted it to you. He already done met your need. Look, when you got before God and you told God what you needed him to do, when you stood up against the adversary and you said, I'm not going to take it. When you start up against the adversary and you told him, I'm not going to take this any longer. You're not going to keep me in this place. You're not going to keep me bound. You're not going to keep me tired. You're not going to keep me sick. You're not going to keep me discouraged. But I'm coming out with a praise on my lips and a worship in my heart. God, you've been good to me. God, you made a way for me. I'm not. And it's going to take right now faith.
Yes, yes, yes.
For it to come to pass.
Yes.
Anybody got a right now praise? Yes. I promise you, your praise is going to shift your situation. They're coming out of our circle. Hey, God. Who are the Messiah? Glory to your name. Glory to your name, God. Glory to your name, God. Hallelujah. Ooh.